In St. Vincent and the Grenadines, the United Labor Party, ULP, of Dr. Ralph Gonzalves won 9 of the 15 parliamentary seats, picking up the North Leeward constituency held by the NDP before elections. Upon his victory, Dr. Gonzalves called on the people to embrace his government's bold vision for the future. First Deputy Leader of the St. Lucia Labor Party, Dr. Ernest Hilaire, says the re-election of Dr. Gonzalves for a fifth consecutive term speaks volumes about the government's principle of putting the people first. According to him, the decision by Dr. Gonzalves to keep the borders open while making the health and safety as well as the economic well-being of the nation a priority has paid off.
So you heard the Prime Minister, Ralph Gonzalves, boasted that his revenue is actually up this year, rather than decreasing like is happening in St. Lucia. He's not incurred the kind of debt that St. Lucia has done, because he's been very strategic in how he has spent his money. And it is always on the basic principle of putting the people first. So it is no surprise to us that not only did he win the election for a fifth term, but he increased the parliamentary majority. The last two election results in St. Vincent were 8-7, 8-7. And for him now to win an additional seat in these difficult times tells you a lot about the approach of the government.
Dr. Hilaire has noticed a trend in the region in which incumbent governments are being re-elected, but he says this is an indication that the people come first.
And you would have seen, certainly in this region, in St. Kitts, in Jamaica, in St. Vincent now, of the government being re-elected. I think in Anguilla there was a change of government. So maybe one can say that, yes, there is a trend, but you also have to look beyond that trend. Causation is a thing to establish. And maybe those governments were governments that were rooted in putting the people first in the pandemic and treating their people as the most important asset. And, you know, maybe that is why.
The SLP's first deputy leader went on to criticize the Chasney administration for the decision to suspend the license of the fisher folk, depriving them of their livelihood. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.